day, everyone. I'm Bayla Phelps, and here with your KMZ News. We have a busy schedule today, so let's get started. First, here I am with presidential candidates. For the 2015-2016 elections, there are many interesting presidential candidates. Our Republican candidates are Donald Trump, Ted Cruz, and Marco Rubio. Trump has had a lead for a few months, and our Democratic candidates are Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders. Hillary and Bernie have been toe-to-toe for this entire election. Well, I thank you for watching. See you next time.
Hello, my name is Anna, and today we're going to be talking about Donald Trump. Donald Trump is in South Carolina in Gaffney giving a speech today, February 18th. Donald is still in the lead. Will he win over South Carolina, or will they not like him? He has 25% overall supporters. Will he get more? He has 16% overall from Florida and 8% overall from Texas. Will he get more from South Carolina? There are questions we can't answer.
Hello, KMS students. I'm Bayla Felton, back here with your KMZ News. Birthdays, everyone. Happy birthday to everyone in KMS. As you have seen, the following sheets are on the walls in the hallways. I'm sure you have signed up or your friends have signed up. Well, now I have a spreadsheet with everyone's birthday, so people will start to take those down accordingly. I have a birthday sheet with everyone in the school's birthdays on it. So, on your birthday, it can be on your birthday, your birth week, or your birth month. It just depends when your birthday is. We will announce it on KMZ. So we hope to see you on KMZ. Bayla Felton signing off.
Hey, Miss Jeanette, how are you doing?
All right, sweetheart.
Thanks for letting us interview you.
Thank you.
So we're here to talk to you about Black History Month.
Okay.
And ask you a couple of questions.
Okay.
So our first question is, when you hear Black History Month, what do you think of?
Our ancestors, with all they went through, you know, try to fight for freedom and stuff like that, to get a right to go drink from the water fountains, ride the same bus, and with all, you know, Martin Luther King, he fought for black people's freedom, and they still not recognizing it as much.
So, what do you do during Black History Month? Is there something special that you do?
No, because we end up working.
What does Black History specifically mean to you? Like when you think about all that people have went through to become, to make our world what we are today, what does it mean to you?
Freedom. Freedom of speech.
Do you try to talk to anybody about Black History?
Try to tell a lot of these, talk to these kids out here, tell them with all our ancestors, and you know, when I was coming up, with all I seen anyway.
Do you have a favorite black leader?
Martin Luther King.
Mm-hmm. Now, you said your favorite leader was Martin Luther King, and now there's disagreements about Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, about how Martin Luther King was peaceful and no hitting back, but Malcolm X said, if somebody hits me, you have the right to hit them back. Who do you agree with more?
At least try to work it out instead of fighting. But like I said, our ancestors went through a lot for us.
Yes, they did.
And the way I watched the film with Martin Luther King when I was real young, our ancestors went through a lot for freedom of speech and the right to ride the bus, to drink from the water fountain together, to eat in the same restaurant. They used to beat and sick dogs. The sick dogs on us and pressure wash us with water hose, our ancestors. They went through a lot for our freedom. They really did.
You need a hug.
You really do. We went through a lot for us. We get where we want now. They really did.
Yes, they did.
And like I said, if y'all watch that film, y'all know what they went through.
Mm-hmm. Welcome to Super Bowl 50 Talk with Ann. The Panthers' luck finally gave out with a loss to the Broncos in Super Bowl 50. It was an astonishing game. The Broncos' defense had 7 sacks on the Panthers and got a touchdown on defense. It was a very good game, but it also rattled some players' cages, like Cam, who walked out on a post-show interview. The Panthers' quarterback, Cam Newton, said on Tuesday, "I don't know what to say, okay? I'm sorry. Show me a good loser, and I'll show you a loser," right before he got up and walked out of the interview. The score was 10-24 Broncos. Not only that, it was also Peyton Manning's last game, and the MVP was Von Miller. Goodbye.
It's time for the moment you've been waiting for.
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone. But when I see you hanging about with anyone, it's not unusual to see me cry. I wanna die. It's not unusual to go out at any time. But when I see you out and about, it's such a crime. If you should ever wanna be loved by anyone, it's not unusual, it happens every day. No matter what you
Hi, you're here with Maya Rosa, and we're interviewing Miss Gregorina.
About STEM.
Hello.
Okay, so Miss Gregorina, what is STEM?
So STEM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math.
Okay. How was Kennedy chosen to be a STEM school?
Kennedy Middle School was already doing some great things with technology, such as being one of the first middle schools to be one-to-one with Chromebooks. We had our TSA club here with Mr. Fernandez already, so the district decided this would be a great fit for our school and students.
Okay. How does STEM help students in their futures?
So there are a lot of STEM careers available, but not a lot of people are taking those jobs, and a lot of those jobs are high-paying jobs. So we're trying to provide a lot of opportunities here to expose students to STEM opportunities, clubs, field trips, guest speakers. I think it's less than 10% females are in STEM careers, so we need a lot of females to go into these careers as well.
What are you going on Wednesday? Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Sure. So we had some representatives from Olympic High School come. They were members of the ROTC, and they were trying to reach out to our female population here and do a STEM-related activity with them. So because there are not enough females in STEM careers, a lot of those jobs are populated with boys, men. So they came here and did an battery-powered car engineering activity with our girls.
Thank you, Ms. Gregorina, for being here with us today. Once again, it's Maya Rosa. Have a good day.
Hello, everybody. We are here at a STEM program, and this is...
My name is Skye Spence. I'm the brigade commander for Olympic High School's JROTC program. What else?
Can you explain to us what STEM is?
STEM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math, and basically what we're trying to do is because less than 10% of women are in STEM, and so we're just trying to expose all the young girls that are in STEM already so they can continue to do it because it's actually a really good program and it gives you a lot of benefits such as like pay and stuff. So we're just trying to get more females involved in it.
Can you explain to us what you have these young girls doing?
Basically, what our team created is a presentation that explains exactly what STEM is and why it's an issue that women are not a part of it. So basically right now, I guess they're creating cars that kind of gives you like a little insight of what you would do if you went into STEM.
Do you see a career in STEM for these young girls?
Yeah, definitely. They seem really interested in what they're doing, and they've been participating really well.
Any insight that you would like to add about STEM?
Basically, just give, well, yeah, let me get my thoughts together. Just give it a chance and make sure you try out all of your options because it is a really good program.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.